Hi there, guys, and welcome back to the Forza Horizon 2 demo. I'm your host, Ross, and these are the events that I was talking about, the Forza Horizon bucket list. This is an insane list of things you must do before you complete the game, or you can do it whenever you want, really. This bucket list is just a taster of what you can expect from the real game, obviously. Now, we start off with one of the three cars you get to drive in this whole entire demo. Drive a Koenigsegg Agera like you stole it. That sounds like a perfect example of my driving style. I drive everything like I stole it. Pretty much why my car's broken at the minute in real life. But hey ho, there you go. This car is powered by a supercharged V8 of some description. It's powered by a 5-litre V8 twin-turbocharged engine producing around about 927 brake horsepower. Essentially, this car is absolutely mental, and forgive my driving, it is terrible. Still trying to get used to the game, and this is a light years gap between the Bowler and this. I mean, going from a four-wheel drive V8 Dakar car to a hypercar is like going from a Fiat Uno and jumping into a Ferrari the next day. It's mental. This car has serious horsepower and not enough grip at all, as I struggle for grip going around a corner. Just about succeeding in that bucket list challenge. This car is mental. I would love to see it. I'd love to see one of these in action in real life. It would just make my day. And obviously you get XP rewards for it as well. I was on my way to the next event when this kind of puzzled me. There was a little white dot in the middle of nowhere, so I thought, hey ho, let's follow it. It was one of my mates, so I was like, okay, fair enough, where's he off to? Obviously they're not real, they're just computer players. And I forgot about the nuke zone as you go through. And Forza Horizon 2 demo doesn't like you wandering off, so you're not allowed to leave this specific area. But, okay, fair enough, so off we plod to the next event. Yeah, using the off-road capability of the Bowler as well, why not? Okay, now we get to the high-speed circuit event. This is a track, well, I say a track-based course. It is essentially a track on a road course. It's still pretty good. It's like a closed circuit race kind of action. Me versus a hell of a lot more 4x4s. I do love the look of the Dodge Ram trophy truck, it has to be said. It does look the part, if anything else, you know. The Bowler's not so bad either, and so do the Rally Fighters. And obviously this is our first taste of rain! Yes, everybody, in the Forza universe, everybody is craved for changeable weather, and now we have it. We have rain, and it's not too bad. The only criticize I have is that when you're behind someone, in real life you get loads more spray on the window. In this, it doesn't really matter where you are, you get the same amount of spray. So, that's my only criticism. I mean, if you're stuck behind someone drafting, you want all the stuff coming up in your face. The track grip level is limited. It is a bit twitchier than normal. Granted, it doesn't show it very well. This is a four-wheel drive V8 monster, so you're not going to expect, you know, Agera-style handling. It's a little bit twitchy, nothing too major. The track detail is a bit better as well when you slow down a bit. It is quite nice to see the puddles and that. It would be nice to see if it affects the handling once you go through a big, like, water splash and maybe a bit of aquaplaning, stuff like that. It is very slippery. I showed the inside just to see the wipers working. It's nice to see that in this game. I try and drift a little bit and I overcook it. Almost hit a tree, but I correct it and get in the way of the Dodge Ram trophy truck. Why not, you know? The big V8 Land Rover. I love the detail to the outside of the car. The outside of the car is what makes it as well, all the water bubbles. And I know it sounds like a little thing, but when an opponent comes up behind you and the lights shine on the back of your car, that is just the little details that make this game ever so more perfect for me. I mean, Forza as a series is a great series. The only downside is there's not a lot of British cars in it. I mean, granted, in this one you've got the Mark II Escort, the Capri, you've got the Rolls-Royce maybe as well, you've got, you know, and the Type 2 bus as well, that's German, but it would be nice to see some of the old classic British cars in here, you know, I don't know, just for example, like the old Range Rover, you know, the big square one, but that could just be me, or some of the old Morgans, that'd be nice, the Plus 8 drifting around on a wood chassis. as I said, there's a few little graphical glitches with the spray as well, like coming through the bed of that Dodge Ram trophy truck, but it is to be expected. I mean, that was quite a good pass, passing 3AI on the inside of a turn. I'm being a bit tentative here. I don't know the track yet. They only give you a couple of laps, so you won't see some full bore racing until I actually get the game. So you can imagine that, you know, oh yeah, he's being a bit of a wimp going around some of these turns. Oh, a little bit, yeah, because I want to try and not look like an idiot, basically. Little dents and dings, obviously expected in a race, but I won it, and that was pretty cool. Very first wet race, so it was an interesting experience nonetheless. And obviously this demo is pretty much over for the single player campaign. Well, I say pretty much, there's one more event coming up. You've just won this championship in the demo, which is nice, you know. That's my new rival, Casino Royale. You will know from another YouTube channel, maybe you do. Yeah, so this game, in a nutshell, is quite, well, I say quite awesome. It is awesome. It's just mental in every way. I'm loving it so far. I'm getting all hyped up because the demo is fulfilling my expectations of what Forza Horizon should be. It's just a fun cruising game, and you can go on road trips with your mates anywhere you fancy. Obviously, like the previous Horizon, there is the XP boards and stuff. This was me just a bit later on from that. The ground's still wet from the race earlier. Just following a dirt road that kind of vanishes on the map, but still appears in the world. So I thought, that's a bit odd. Right, fair enough, must be extra content, you know, when they're building the game, you're just leaving extra roads. Maybe it might be a new junkyard space for a car or something like that. That'd be pretty cool. And obviously the car gets quite dirty driving on dirt roads, that's a nice little touch. A thing that I wish they would, my driving failing again, I wish they would put on the mini-maps is the positions of walls. Because I didn't see that until I straight up hit it, so that would be nice. Save me some future accidents as well, and less damage on my car. Speed ahead to when we get to the event. This is the, in the first Horizon game, they did showground events where you would beat a plane with a Mustang or something like that. Same basic principle, only this time they've ramped it up a bit because you, instead of one plane, you're against the entire display team. And of course, we're back in our favourite Lambo, this beautiful V10 Screamer, as we get off the line. This is with all assists off in this car, so I am being a little bit tentative. Obviously new track, but I want to try my best as well. The car does understeer quite badly, I've noticed this, and it's only because it's obviously uneven ground, pushing possibly a bit too hard in the corners, but there is a lot of understeer. I hope and pray that you can tune these cars in this game, and I think I did see a tuning menu, so we can get the understeer out of these cars, finally. Me and my mates, ages and ages spent trying to find the fastest car in Forza Horizon, but the only downside is you couldn't tune them, so you had a 900 horsepower Supra and it would only do 170, you know, it's a bit short on the old leash. The car, this Lambo is absolutely superb. It feels like I'm racing through Monte Carlo. It just feels very street race-esque. It feels like I'm driving on a road course. It just feels right in every way, every sense of the word. The car is performing well. It doesn't do well over uneven ground. If you're going around a corner and it's slightly rough, it does get a bit twitchy, I presume, as any other car would. Granted, I'm doing 100 plus miles an hour, so that really doesn't help. Here's the little bit twitchy moment. Left, right, come on, save it. Don't look like an idiot. And obviously the display team rumbling overhead makes the whole screen shake. Harder to focus on the corners. That's an expensive repair bill if you ever hit a lamppost with a real Lambo. The car feels planted at best, and then it understeers, and obviously you get the twitching as well. It feels more natural. The car just feels alive. It's a great experience to drive. I bet it's even better in real life. The game's as close as I'm ever going to come to driving a Lamborghini, but hey-ho, you never know what's in the future. And the display team looks pretty awesome as well, showing the Italian colours. I'm not sure where this country is, but I know Nice is in France. Thank you very much for replying that in the comments. Nice is in France, I did forget that. As we cross the finish line, I just about beat the display team. obviously making it all showy and trying to get around there as fast as I can. I was only just quicker than them. It was that close. And obviously the Lambo's showing a bit worse for wear, a little bit of wing damage, possibly some door damage as well. Might need a new door skin. That could do with a bit of tuning, I think. Where the bodywork ripples, that could do with a bit of fine sort of like detailing. See if you can improve that a bit more. Forza guys, come on, make the damage more realistic. I just love the fact that this guy's on the phone. Everybody's in like really high performance sports cars. There's me in the bowler behind the cameraman. Like, guys, where's my fast car? No, it's not fair. Don't get me wrong, the bowler's a beast, but I can guarantee I can make it faster. I might be able to keep up with a standard Lambo, you never know. And this is obviously where the demo ends, unfortunately. You get to this point and then it pops up with the screen, oh, I wish you could join us, and it comes up with purchase options. I wasn't aware they could do this in demos. Basically, like a pre-purchase thing. Obviously, you get three choices. You get the day one edition, which is just the game on its own. You get day one car packs. Day one deluxe edition, you get full, or you just get, it's more and more increased bits. I presume the car pass for the second one, and then obviously the VIP bit for the Ultimate Edition. That's the one that I will be pre-ordering, hopefully, and getting on release date, so you'll be seeing plenty more Forza Horizon 2 footage from me, which is always nice. Just going through some of the details there on the sales screen. It does look pretty cool. I can't wait to play it myself, the full game. The first car that I will be getting is the the Ford Capri 3100 RS 3100, or I just call it the RS 3 liter, because it is absolutely beastly. Now this is just a teaser of what you can expect for the multiplayer games. Obviously I can see the Land Rush games in stupid cars already. I can see night races. I can see Bulldog. I always reminisce of drift races, you know, that sort of same level of awesome fun. You can go on full length road trips, so instead of planning your, well, instead of stopping at each destination and then trying to sort something out, you can go on the road trips and the game will sort it all out for you. Obviously, like catch the mouse and that sort of stuff is all good. And yeah, it's looking really awesome, and all of this stuff just adds to the excitement of the game. I really want to get the game now and just show off all the awesomeness that is there. And you just saw the Type 2 bus there. I'm sure they're all going that speed, because I think that's as fast as the Type 2 bus can go standard. The old little air-cooled engine just ticking away. About 4 hours later, I was driving around. My internet is so bad, and the games must have been so full. It finally found me an online session, so I can show you guys what the online stuff's all about. Welcome to Online Free Roam with your Bowler Wildcat. This is where I found out that I picked the really wrong car for any sort of racing. I'm just driving along, and then, oh, we started an A-class race. Okay, let's join that one. Apparently my favourite radio station's Bass Arena. Obviously it's Bass, come on, I'm not stupid. Sinking traffic vehicles. This is the first look at the car select screen. For a brief moment, I suppose I had to, you know, hurry up, otherwise it would have kicked me out of the event. We're on the same circuit as we were on the wet race in the single player, so it gives you the choice of two again. Gives you a garage breakdown, how much stuff you own. And there's barn finds back again, which is absolutely amazing. There's speed traps as well, as I said. It shows you all of your stats as you're setting up this race, and it shows you everything, because it takes a while to set it up. It's a fair old long waiting time, this one. I don't know why I didn't skip it out of the video, but oh well, never mind. You get to see some nice HD bits of the bowler. It's nice. And we're on the online free roam high speed circuit race. Yeah, I picked the wrong car. I'm racing against Evos. I was not expecting this at all. I think I was the only one speaking, bar a three-year-old. But that's what you're getting online on Forza. Three-year-olds and my sort of age people. It's an odd combination. But it works. And you know, you always get that one person on any Forza Online game that just slides into the corner and takes everybody out? I had to deal with that on the first corner. Watch this, guys. Coming down to the first corner, braking hard, trying to keep up with the leader. Smack! There we go, straight onto the dirt. Okay, fair enough. Not a problem. Maybe it was just a little bit of contact. Swoop, smack again. There we go. There he is. Trying to outdo the Evo there. At least he gave me a bit of room. Then he scraped me again. I hate people that just have random X's in their name. What is that like? What are you, five? Come on. Coming back into the corners, everybody's flat out. I'm struggling with my very wobbly Bowler Wildcat. It's quite the quick car. He was going a bit off-road, that's fine. You can do in the Evo X. And then me trying to scramble back up to the leader. Tries to cut the corner, slams into the wall. This guy is really trying to out to get me. Going into the corner is a bit too hot there, I think. A little bit understeer wide, but I am in a truck compared to these guys. Then it's weird going into that turn specifically. It seems to compress the suspension and shake it a bit because I lose steering for just a fraction of a second. Now it's like understeer onwards, so I have to sort of bide my time going into that corner. Flat out down the max straight. I think this is a different alteration to the to the rainy circuit actually. As we go through the left-hander again, trying every best effort to catch up with the leader, I'm just not in the quicker car. And the guy behind me is still trying to take me out, just going to using the bit of off-road there. Using all of the track to my capabilities. It's a fantastic thing once you get this wound up. You can go anywhere at any speed. This bowler can destroy things. But it's not destroying the places. I am holding second firm. I'm catching up to him though, just a little bit at a time. I think the years of racing is finally catching up with me. I'm getting used to it now, throwing the car into corners a bit faster, a bit harder. Cutting the corner just nicely there. I mean, I am in a four-wheel drive car, and there's no curbs on this one, so it's always a good thing. It's just a little bit of lost traction there. It just shudders a little bit, and then it gets back underway again. Hairing down the back straight. I've caught back really close up to him now. 136 miles an hour in a four-wheel drive Dakar rally car is scary. Braking hard for the next corner. We both go a little bit wide there. It doesn't really matter on this game because there's no go slow grass, which is amazing. Go slow tarmac as well. Coming through the next section now, going flat out even more. Just clipping it slightly, knocking down that same post. I'm sure it respawns. Booting it down the back straight again. Coming to the flick right. Just clip the checkpoint there, coming over the hill as fast as you can, flat out, trying not to lose as much speed as I can, trying not to scrub as much speed off as I think I should do, and going in for the tight left-hander, get a better run than he does. I was well in for catching him at this point. Like, I will catch up to you, I will do this, we'll do that. He got a bit sideways there, and then I do the stupidest thing and I miss the checkpoint. Why would I do that? Oh, I ruined the race for myself. So the guy with the middle in X is in his name crosses in front of me. No, that was, he's still behind me, so I presume he got passed. This guy's got a Z in front of his name. And he's quite the avid racer because I couldn't catch up to him to the finish. So that was my own mistake. I finished third. That's not too bad. First ever race online. I think I got a fairly good lap time as well. And obviously with the online races, you get the online bucket list as well, which is awesome. This is the same one again. It's the Koenigsegg Agera. And I get one willing participant. You, sir, are a legend of a man. Teamwork, spelt T-E-A-M-W-R-K. You are awesome. Go add him. Spam the living daylights out of him, I dare you. And because there's two cars, one spawned behind me in a bench. Broke the bench. I don't know how that's supposed to work, but you're supposed to be a combined target of 150 miles an hour. So now I'm used to the Agera a little bit now, so we pound along the racetrack. Sod this turn here, let's just go straight through the vineyards, knocking over poles and almost going through a forest. That was I was quite clenched going through there, about 170 miles an hour. This car is mentally quick. Honestly, anybody, I mean, Koenigseggs as a general rule don't change. They're always the same sort of, like, massive power, slight, very lightweight cars. But I'm glad you enjoyed, guys. This has been the first look at the Forza Horizon 2 demo. Take care, and I'll see you in the full game.